to use your yarn changer on your Studio Singer Silver Reed machines, this is the Studio SK360 standard gauge. This is the YC5, yarn changer 5. I believe the 6 is very similar to this. I'm not positive though. And what you're going to do, and with all yarn changers, I believe they're all the same, you're going to take your sponge bar and push it in just a little bit so that this little notch could slip into that place. And then after you get it all nice and snug up against the machine, then you're going to take and tighten the knob there. And then you're going to thread your yarns into your four-color yarn mask. Now, this is a special mask that you should have gotten with your yarn changer. If not, you could probably use the two-thread yarn changer, but you're going to have to take one color out and put the new color in. So it's better if you do find the four-color yarn mask. Now, I have this on my tilt stand. I have my cover in the back as my tray, so I have my four cones behind, and then I have the dark blue over here on the left, the magenta in the center, the white in the center, and the light blue on the right. So on the yarn changer, you have A, B, C, and D. You also have 0, which means it's not in use, 1, it's holding the yarn, and 2, that will grab the next yarn. As you see, this little tripper here will bring it up, but you have to have it in 1 to reset it and press the orange button on the side to bring it back down. Just as on the yarn changer, you start on the left, so we got A, B, C, and D. So this is your main yarn, and these are your contrasting color yarns that you're going to be working with. Okay, so you're going to cast on. You're going to take your side levers and bring them forward to the circle. You're going to have your cam lever to stop a knot. And you want to have the tension dial to 0. On the ribber, tension dial to 0. Both the cam levers to 1. The side levers to the equals. You do want the pitch at half pitch 5 or H5. And then bring out whatever needles you're going to do. Now I'm bringing up 3 sets of repeats for the punch card, so I've got 36 left to right. And then you also need to, the ribber needs to, on the left, needs to have that needle on the end. So you're going to knit one row, and it does that zigzag cast on. Then you're going to take your ribber comb, pull the wire out the top, and then push from underneath, push the ribber comb into place so that it goes between the stitches, and then thread that wire back through again, and then hang your barrel weights. Now I feel underneath to just outside the knitted area. And I think 2 of the large ones would be enough. So now what I'm going to do is put my left cam lever on the ribber to 0, and I'm going to put the tension dial both to 1, and I am going to knit one row. Now that did knit on the knitter bed only. I take the knitter carriage, put it to slip, the cam lever to slip, knit one row, and that knitted on the ribber bed only. I put the cam lever on the knitter back to stockinette and knit one more row. And again, that does it on the back. Now I take and push the side levers on the knitter carriage back to the triangles. I make sure both of the front cam levers are to 1. I'm going to put my tension dial up to 2, And everything else is all set. Now I just start knitting back and forth. And it does a full needle rib, so it's doing the zigzag back and forth. Well, I thought it was. Yeah, it was hard for me to see the river needles going, and with the stitches really tiny, I couldn't really tell. So now I end over here on the right. I'm going to take my other three yarns, and I need to bring it over the top of the left yarn. Now you can tie a knot in these to hold them together, and then you want to get it slipped down between the beds and reach underneath, and you should be able to get it. And then I'm gonna, well, let me make a little slip knot here, a loop I mean, and I will take this loop and put it on the clamp. And I could go over to the clamp on the side here. Now what I need to do is set these yarns into the right parts of the yarn changer. So now what I do is I will press the A button in. I will take the trip lever and pull that out. I will press in the B button, press the trip leader. And then I bring the second yarn, being careful not to get it wound around the gate pegs, and you bring it behind this wire, and then I'm going to press the C button, and then put the white in that one, press the D button, press the trip lever, and that way I can get the light blue in. Oops. Okay. Well, if it doesn't do it, you could reach from behind and get it done. What I need to do is, okay. So I'm going to start out with A being up in the two position, B being in the one position, so I'm going to be using the second color, the magenta here, as the second color. C and D are going to stay in the zero position until I need them. Okay, so now you're going to pick out a card. You should have gotten some cards with your yarn changer. And I think you can kind of make out that this has a sailboat in it. Now, you also should have got what's called a check card. Now, if you look at it, you've got numbers on one side. You take the card and put it over the check card so it lines up the bottom, right on the bottom there. And as you look, you can see the blue makes out the sailboat. Of course, now, the orange color, that's going to be the dark blue. The magenta is going to be the boat bottom, and then the sails are going to be white. So all the orange is the background color. So now you want to get your card put in. Bring it through, have the lever here on the triangle set back so that you could bring it. And then you take your clips, and you take the back side first, put the clip underneath it, and then take the front side and overlap it on the top. That way it doesn't get caught down inside the machine. So you go ahead and set this to row one. Something else I forgot to mention, just to the left of the number is a bold line on two rows, and it has the letter B. So that tells me that I should be using B yarn in my machine. Then it goes up to A, B, A, B, A. It's going to go back and forth between the blue and the magenta. And then I get up to row 17. That's where I'm going to press the C button, and I'll be using the blue, A and C, the blue and the white, and then go back to just the blue. So the other thing you do need to do is you've got your tripper here for your yarn changer. I like this one because it does it automatically. You do want to set your cam lever to slip and then just start knitting away. Going all the way over past so that the tripper moves this thing, and now it's going to grab the second yarn. Well, it was supposed to. There we go. And right now that just knitted on the river. And it looks like the river again. Go past the little trip there so that it changes the yarn. Now here's something I wanted. Let me get a close-up of this so I could show you what the card is actually doing here. Now, down on whatever row it was, I guess 6, because we're on 7 here, the card told the knitting machine, the knitter part of it, to only knit these stitches. So if you didn't have the ribber, these ones in blue would actually been slipped or tucked, actually slipped because there's too much. So the yarn would go underneath it. So as you could see, here's my 3 sailboats. So just continue knitting until you see this letter C on the card for us to change colors. And here we are. So now I am going to press in C. It brings B back. So now it's going to go between A and C. And now I'm back to row 1, and it tells me to have in B. So I would continue going through this, and this is going to make your design. And the good thing about this is there's no floats like you have on Fair Isle. The floats are caught in between the knitter and the ribber stitches, the way this is set up. So you'll find a lot of uses for this, I'm sure. Now here's the back of the finished piece. You have 2 rows of each color. It's hard to see because of the small stitches, but... And I think the camera's kind of picking up the sails of the sailboat. But to the naked eye, it's harder to see that. And then when you turn it around, there you have your sailboats. Now you probably can see the colors in between there, but from a distance it's going to be hard to see. And I would prefer this over having long floats. If this was Fair Isle, you would have the long floats in between here on the white. So the double jacquard is going to be a really interesting technique to work with.